Solar cycle 25 is currently intensifying, with a surge in the influx of light particles or photons bombarding Earth. If you are particularly sensitive to these changes, you may detect them with heightened awareness. Suddenly experiencing headaches or joint pain out of the blue could be a symptom. Some individuals may also feel an overwhelming fatigue or exhaustion, signaling the need to pause, relax, and prioritize self-care. The sun's magnetic flip within this ongoing solar cycle is markedly increasing, and nature displays signs of this phenomenon. This is the 28th video in the series Basic Ways of Healing Yourself in Nature. In the northern part of Earth, we are in the late springtime at this moment, and there is a big amount of colors in nature. CMEs, coronal mass ejections, interacting with Earth's magnetosphere, can produce spectacular auroras or northern and southern lights, particularly at high latitudes. While auroras are visually stunning, they are a manifestation of geomagnetic storms caused by space weather events. While auroras themselves are not harmful to humans, increased geomagnetic activity associated with CMEs can lead to disruptions. Studies suggest a possible link between solar activity and human behavior and mental health. While the mechanisms underlying this association are not fully understood, it has been suggested that changes in geomagnetic activity and ionospheric parameters during solar events may affect biological systems, including the human brain. Research in this area is ongoing. Earth is being bombarded with photons, particles of light. The sun returns light to Earth through the emission of photons. Photons are the fundamental particles of light, carrying electromagnetic radiation. The human body emits a faint glow known as ultra-weak photon emission. Though it's far too subtle for our eyes to perceive directly. This phenomenon, often referred to as biophoton emission, occurs as a result of energy metabolism within cells. While the intensity of this emitted light is approximately 1,000 times lower than what our naked eyes can detect, sensitive instruments can capture and measure this subtle energy release. Biophoton emission reflects the dynamic processes happening within our bodies at the molecular level, offering insights into metabolism and cellular activity. The connection between the sun, nature, and human biophoton emission lies in the fundamental processes of energy metabolism and cellular activity. Sunlight serves as a primary source of energy for life on Earth. Photons emitted by the sun provide the energy necessary for photosynthesis in plants, which generates oxygen and produces organic molecules that form the basis of the food chain. Ultimately, the energy derived from sunlight is transferred through the food we eat, supporting cellular metabolism and biophoton emission in humans. Nature provides the environment and resources that support human health and well-being. Spending time in natural environments exposes individuals to sunlight, fresh air, and green spaces, which have been shown to reduce stress, enhance mood, and improve overall health. Immersion in nature can promote optimal physiological functioning, including energy metabolism and biophoton emission. Regarding whether some people glow more than others, it's essential to clarify that the term glow in this context typically refers to metaphorical and symbolic attributes such as radiance, vitality, or inner light, rather than literal luminosity. While all humans emit biophotons as part of normal physiological processes, variations in diet, lifestyle, and health status can influence the overall vitality and radiance of an individual. Factors such as regular exercise, a balanced diet, adequate sleep, stress management, and emotional well-being can contribute to a healthy glow and vibrant appearance. So, do this heightened solar activity actually promote a lift in human consciousness? And are we all supposed to evolve from this massive amount of energy streaming towards us? If you look at the multitude of people sharing photos of the Northern Lights over the past couple of days, you can already sense a kind of gratitude emanating from them for being able to witness this amazing display of light in the night skies. And perhaps this is what we all should learn, that we are each a small part of something much larger and more massive than ourselves. That we are part of a chain reaction where our actions are sometimes beyond our control. The sun, the light, can thrust us back in time. In a fleeting moment of extreme solar activity, like the Carrington event. CMEs can influence human physiology and health in various ways, including cellular processes. Geomagnetic storms can cause disturbances in Earth's ionosphere, the upper layer of the atmosphere. Changes in ionospheric conditions may impact the propagation of radio signals, which are utilized by cells for intercellular communication and coordination in biological processes. This has been associated with changes in the autonomic nervous system and stress response pathways. It may trigger physiological stress responses, including alterations in heart rate variability, blood pressure, and cortisol levels. Geomagnetic storms may contribute to genomic instability and DNA damage in human cells. Exposure to geomagnetic fluctuations may increase the risk of DNA strand breaks, chromosomal aberrations and mutations, potentially affecting cellular integrity and function. Changes in geomagnetic activity have been linked to alterations in white blood cell counts, which play a crucial role in the body's defense against pathogens and foreign invaders. It might affect the pineal gland's sensitivity to environmental cues, leading to alterations in melatonin secretion and potentially disrupting cellular circadian rhythms. So, should we live in fear of this? Or should we instead adapt to the reality that we are small parts of the universe? The influx of photons may indeed induce changes in our human DNA. Hopefully for the better. The intensity and frequency of biophoton emission, our human glow, may vary among individuals. We are all products of the same universe, with the potential to radiate more light towards each other, if we learn to live harmoniously as part of nature. While the precise mechanisms underlying the effects of geomagnetic storms on cellular reactions in humans are still not fully understood, emerging research suggests that geomagnetic activity may influence various physiological processes at the cellular level. Further studies are needed to elucidate the mechanisms of action and potential health implications of geomagnetic storms on human biology. The amazing aurora is far more than a beautiful sight. And as we are beings of light, the massive amount of light particles streaming towards us at the moment deeply affect us. We just don't know how much yet. So with this video in the basic series, I will recommend that you show a little more respect towards yourself in these days of high solar activity. It is important to eat fresh food, drink clean water, and relax more than you used to. It is as the universe, nature, God, is telling us something important at the moment. That maybe the things we strive towards in our modern life is not what we were supposed to do. Stay grounded in nature. Seek support in the vibrations from the green leaves and the old giant trees with their hundreds of years lifespan. Put your hands on the ground, in the grass, in the soil. Connect to nature and return to your natural glow with the massive amounts of light coming in. I will, as always, put some links in the description box below, and I will return soon with new content on this channel. Please share, like, and subscribe, and you are welcome to contact me on email for any questions. Stay kind and shine your light.